Today in this class we discuss about the VLOOKUP and LOOKUP formula. VLOOKUP and like a LOOKUP formula, not only for VLOOKUP, called the LOOKUP method. What is the LOOKUP method? The first need the requirement for the LOOKUP, VLOOKUP and LOOKUP formula. I have the data here. This is the master data. We have a lot of data here. And we have, this is the my unique ID. It's like employee ID, account ID, like that. This is the unique ID. So some people give me the sirf unique ID, only for unique ID here. And need to details like date, name, city, area, other thing. So there's detail in the hours data sheets. So how can we get the data? So we have the two way. First way, we have copy the our ID and go to the data sheet and paste here and paste to search and select the data and copy to your locations. But problem is that if you have the 3 to 4 5 data IDs, then you have copied the data. But you have the lot of the data and every time will be changed, so everybody need a copy and this is a big jobs. That time we have used the VLOOKUP formula and lookup method. Lookup method not work in the Excel, work the every software. Just like college time, you have check your result from your college website. Just go to the website, enter your roll number, roll code, and just click the search, your result will be appear. So how can appear? So lookup method search your roll number to millions of your student database. Like that, go to the bank, banker just asks the account number and you give the account number, just put the account number in your software and you'll get the detail in the millions databases, the customer databases. So this is the lookup method. So you have applied the VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP to work with, we have lookup the one particular unique ID to one table and show the record your record according to your columns. So first is the lookup value, select the lookup value, select the table area. So table area, go to the table area. But remember, you have searched the your unique ID just like ID, then table area also selection with ID because your pivot table left to right search, not right to left. So you have your data table, the first column is your unique ID. So VLOOKUP search your ID in the first column. And just like check the column, is he get the eight cells. It's like B, C, D, eight columns. But give the one cell, give the one cell address, one cell value. So here need to enter the column number, which column you have appear the data, show the data on the table. So we have show the date, so we have write here date, comma, 04 exact match. Enter, you can see here. We have name, we also type the name. One VLOOKUP, one cell, one VLOOKUP. One column, one VLOOKUP. Select the data. Now we have three. Column number three, enter. Give the name. For city, VLOOKUP, select the date. Data. And one city is the 4, 0 city area VLOOKUP. So you can apply the VLOOKUP like that, but problem is that we have apply one by one. If we have the number of column 50 column, 40 column, 100 column, that time take the more time for apply the VLOOKUP. That time we have drag and drop. How can drag? For the dragging, need to absolute and freeze your cells. Is it just like I have freeze the column A, and here is the freeze our range, and press the enter, and we have this drag here. But problem is the same result appear because every column have the same numbers. Your number is the manual, so need to enter a number is manual, one by one, like 7. 8, 9, like that. But also we have the problem. Every column need to your column numbers. So how can do the column number alternate? So we have more and more tricks for that. First is we have just insert the one row number above your data and enter the column number here 3, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now we have applied the VLOOKUP formula here. Select the unique ID, go to the data table, and here is not enter your column manually. Just go to the sheet 4 and select the manual. Select here your sequence number and comma 0. Now need to drag. Before the drag, we apply here dollar sign for O because we have dragged top to down that time. A4 is fixed, 4 is not fixed, A is fixed. 4 increase to 5, 6, 7, like that measure. And B1, we have applied the dollar sign only for 1. So we have drag. But problem is that for this example, need to one row. But I don't want to insert any row. So yesterday we discussed about the column formula. Column formula give the column number, just like 2. And we also require 2 in the VLOOKUP. So why not use this column formula in the VLOOKUP? So apply the VLOOKUP here, select the IDs, you go to the data, select your data, comma, and we have applied the formula column. Column formula in the row and comma 0. Yes, enter. You can get here record. And now we have need to freeze here. In column formula not need to freeze it and type there. But problem is that if you have applied the column formula, need to a data start from your start first row, first cells. If you have a start from another cells, then column number not work here. That time we have used the array concept. Just like we have apply formula and drag and freezing and drag and drop. I don't want to apply multiple VLOOKUP here. I want to apply single VLOOKUP value, but I want to get the result all in the one time. That time we have applied the VLOOKUP with array. So VLOOKUP, select here, go to the data, and we have the 9 column numbers. So in the curly bracket, we have typed the all column number here according to your column positions. Hello? पोस्ट ऑफिस पे ना बोल रहा है, पोस्ट ऑफिस के ऊपर है, दो तल्ला पे है, सेकंड फ्लोर पे, मैंने कि तीन तल्ला पे, हाँ, लेहुर ना होती कोई लेडीज ही पहुँचा दी, हाँ, फोन कर, sorry sir. So we have applied the formula here 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this is not need to enter sequence. Enter your number according your column positions. Comma 0. And just press the control shift enter. Okay? I have repeated. Let's just check. Need to first select your locations where you apply VLOOKUPs. Check your column here column positions and your data column positions and calculate your column numbers in the anywhere 1, 2, 3, 4 title. and now we have applied the VLOOKUP with selection, not change the selection, select your locations, cells, and apply the VLOOKUP and go to the data. And we have in the curly bracket applied all column number here using the comma 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and this is not necessary. You have entered the sequentially, you have entered the according with column position, right sir? Comma 0 for
example. The number is from 2 to 9 continuously without break, so
This is not necessary. You have typed the sequentially. You have typed the number according your column positions.
No. What I am telling is, as it is from 2 to 9, can we write 2-9?
No. We have need to comma sequentially. If you have the lot of columns that you want to apply, write the manually 1-9. We have the just like 1-40, 1-60 like that, right? So you have column formula for that. See here. You want to write the numbers in the one time, then use the column formula in the column slash the 1-by-1. Okay, but this is a sequentially. Control shift. Oh no! Wait 1 second. Row formula. No, this is not a good method. If you have the data vertically, that time we have used this method. You can't change the one single results. You have changed the top to dog vertically, then you have used this formula. Control shift. Okay, but for the vertically, horizontally, no have any formula, because column formula not give the 1-9 like column. He give the 1-16,000 column numbers. Okay, but we have another formula. Just like we have the sum not we have the field is not sequence. Every time will be changed here. So we have the another formula, match. We have discussed the match formula in the last time. So match formula, check your cell value in the your column and row and give the sequence number. That's it. We give the 3 and VLOOKUP need to also 3, then VLOOKUP and go to the data, comma, and use the match, select the match result and comma G. You have get the result here. Okay, so you have used the VLOOKUP and match, and you have not required write the column numbers manually, but remember your column field both of the column field will be same spelling. If you have changed the spelling, that time you have got the problem. Okay, Mr. Kishan?
Yeah.
and we have applied the dollar, and carefully we have applied the dollar signs, and we have drag it. So this is the VLOOKUP. So do you understand the VLOOKUP, Mr. Krishnan?
Yeah.
Okay, now we have give the example of match or index. So we have the data here, and in this data my ID is not starting from one. My ID is in the middle of the data. So if I want to the quantity of your 10 ID number, that time we have apply here VLOOKUP. You have use it because VLOOKUP give the I quantity, but VLOOKUP can't give the name and city, because VLOOKUP every time work left to right, not a right to left. Okay, that time how can you use? So we have used the formula match. So here understand the match formula. In match, we have select the data ID and comma 0. This is the 11 number. So you have just understand this element number, not this row number. So there is no link with row numbers and this match results. Match results give the counting, just like we have now insert the one row. So now here is the 12 number. This is the 12 number row, but match give the 11. Why? Because match is starting from 2 number row, and match give the result according the count index number. It is match count your cells. Just like you have check here and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and give the result number 11. Okay, Mr. Krishnan, do you understand match results?
No.
Some people have a confusion. He match give the row numbers, like this row numbers. So this is the wrong. Match give the row index number, column index number. Okay? It is clear, Mr. Krishnan? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have the one formula, index. Index formula, select your data and give the row number and column number. So we give the 11 number and column number is the 2. So give the data class. Okay, when you have changed 11 to 12, then give the 12 number data. So that time we have this row number connect with match results. After that, this formula look like the lookup. So we have write the 15 number, give the 15 number, the Pankaj, the 15 number is the Pankaj. Okay, so need to merge your formula in the index here, the row number, match formula. So we have used the match or index formula, and we have created the new lookup method, lookup formula, like a lookup formula, not lookup formula, like a VLOOKUP formula. And this formula no have validations, his work left to right. That time you can use anywhere. But problem is that need to select your all data. Maybe in future your data will be up increase and decrease. That time need to both of the data increase and decrease. For that we have used the another formula, offset. Offset, no need to select your all data. Just select the starting of the data, and this is the row number, to select the row number, but he is the count here, offset count start from the 0. So if you have enter row number, please less than one row number less. So we have less one number of row because this is starting one. It's like index start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and offset start 0, 1, 2, 3. So index has a 3 and offset has a 4. So we have need to minus one row, and also this is the 0 and 1 column. So index have a 2 number columns, but offset have a 1 column number 1, because offset start from counting 0. So if you have connect your match formula in offset, you have also created the new another formula for like look like a VLOOKUP, and this formula no need to select your all data, select only for starting of the data. So Mr. Kristen, do you understand this formula?
Yeah.
Now if you have used the latest Excel, just like 2019, so no need to apply this type of formula. Here is the X lookup formula include as a VLOOKUP, include as a X match index, everything included here. So select the lookup value and select the table and lookup array. Which column you look up the 15 numbers. So we have select these numbers. And second is the return array. What value will be returned according to your ID number? So you want to return the name. So select the name. Second thing, if not found, so here is no need to apply if error formula. So give the data not found. Okay, match mode we have given the 0. And search mode no need to apply here. You have give the results. So if you have the X lookup, no need to VLOOKUP, no need to match, no need to index, no need to offset for the lookup your data.
Okay.
So do you understand X lookup?
Yeah.
Okay. Now my data is the. My data is the horizontal way. Right click, paste spatial, and this is the transpose of data. So this my data is the horizontal way. And now I want to name of 7 number ID. But here is the VLOOKUP is not applied. That time we have used the HLOOKUP formula. Look like VLOOKUP, but HLOOKUP. So lookup value, select the table area just like VLOOKUP, but lookup VLOOKUP select the vertical, but HLOOKUP select the horizontal, and row index number VLOOKUP column index number, then HLOOKUP row index number. The row number is 3, we have rather 3, and exact match for 0. Okay. And we have also applied the match index here, apply the match formula. A match formula look up the match in the ID number horizontally and comma 0, because match is work horizontally and vertically also. So this is the 8 number column. Now we have used the formula index, select the data, and row number is 3 and column number is 8, the match result. So if you have combined the match index, but here is the match in the column number, not a row numbers. That we have also used the look like a HLOOKUP formula. And if you use the index formula, that time we have used the also offset formula. Offset, select the start of the data, row number is 2, and we have give the match result, but less than 1. We have give the result here. But again, you have the XLOOKUP formula, no need to this data of the data. XLOOKUP, the lookup value, select. XLOOKUP also work the horizontally and vertically. Okay, Ms. Krishnan, do you understand the XLOOKUP formula?
Yes, sir.
So now we have you understand the lookup formula. Mr. Kristen, you have remember when you start the topic, if topic, we have discussed the one slab incentive, just like 0 to 40, 41 to 80, 81 to 100, and greater than 100. And we have in the slab here. 500, 1000, 1500, and 5000. Okay. You can also use this formula through this method with VLOOKUPs, VLOOKUP formula. But how?
Okay.
So we have need to change your data pattern. So we have right here 0, 500, 41, 1000. So we have every slab, the start number right here, and give the next column the values. Then 81, 1500, and 101, 5000. And we have apply here VLOOKUP formula. VLOOKUP, lookup value, and select this data. Comma, 2 comma. This is not a 0, this is the true. You can also write the 1. Because we have write the 0, we have write the 0 in the VLOOKUP because in the Excel, 0 equal to false and 1 equal to true. Now you can get the results. So if you have write the true in the lookup range in the VLOOKUP, that time this is the group looking. This is like the check, is this number 84 number, which number had a between? 84 number is the between in the 81 and 101. So give the result in the 1500. Okay, Mr. Krishnan? But remember, your number in the sequence. If your number is the mix-up number, it's like 41 and niche also 31, that time we have problem. Okay?
Okay.
You can also apply the VLOOKUP formula. If you have the right here true, then true. Then you can get the results like here. If you have applied this method, no need to nested VLOOKUP, nested if. Mr. Kristen, if you apply this type of the example with VLOOKUPs, no need to apply nested if.
Okay.
But you can also apply the lookup formula here. Lookup, select the lookup values, the lookup factor, and result. No, sorry, there is the mistake. Need to select your data. Lookup factor one by one and result factor, just like XLOOKUP. That time you can give the result. But what benefit of the lookup formula? With lookup formula, you have give the result in the curly bracket. So no need to write the your slab in anywhere. So you can also write the slab in your formula. 500, 1000, 1400, and 5000. Okay, Mr. Krishnan, do you understand lookup formula?
Yeah.
So here is we have finished the lookup method formula, but we have the tricks of the VLOOKUPs. We have the many problem. If you have start work with VLOOKUP, you have many problem in the VLOOKUP. Just like if you have the with two conditions, you want two conditions. That time what can do? If you have the not complete, it's like in the data have a Neetu Singh, but your searching location have only for Neetu. That time what can we do? If you have the data in the multiple time, that time what can you do? Okay, so we have discussed the next classes for this. First, you have practice on the VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, match, index, offset, and XLOOKUP and lookup formula. Okay. Hello, Mr. Krishnan.
Yeah.
Okay. So meet on Monday, and we have discussed everything on the lookup method. So on Monday, we have discussed the tricks of the lookup method.
Okay,
bye.